And definitely, like I think of kicking and passing both like a set of golf clubs each. Like there's different rules and ideas and techniques for each of your golf clubs. Like it's not just one rule for everything.
Do you find there's much crossover between AFL style kicking, or have you taken much from it? Or would you reckon rugby might learn anything else from it?
I have. There's so much of AFL kicking is basically like our crossfield kick in rugby. It's quite a tight, accurate kick, around about 60 to 70% of your power. But in rugby, we need that max kick. So a kicker that's got a big exit boot, a long range kick at goal, is such a valuable part of the team. And even in AFL, like there's only a handful of players in each team that actually do take the big, plus 50 kicks and pull the trigger on a massive kick. Everyone else is pretty tight from 40 out and do your job and kick your goals. So that's one thing I have taken away from. They have their style and technique that they coach, which is very knee flicky, very, very small, very tight and compact, because that's what you want to be accurate in their game. We need to explore, those big strong slings, the rodeo arm, the right glute for that power for the big kick, because that's where your key person in the game can have a big impact on rugby, is by having the big boot. And definitely, like I think of kicking and passing both like a set of golf clubs each. Like there's different rules and ideas and techniques for each of your golf clubs. Like it's not just one rule for everything.
With the kicking, so the majority of this stuff, if you learn from trial and error, if you learn from other coaches jumping in and giving you some advice, or would you record yourself? And now that you've got the sort of ability to coach yourself through kicking?
Yeah, and that's the beauty that we're in, is that anyone, like our 10 pillars are all up on YouTube. Anyone can watch. It's like a 25-minute video on them all. And then just take a video of yourself and just compare what you're doing to what I'm sort of throwing out there. And also mimicking the professionals. Like we should all have favorite kickers. We should all try to emulate kickers, because then we get an understanding of why they do it, why they've been successful. So if you've sort of got those younger kickers that aren't too sure about stuff, like get them to latch onto a kicker and watch Owen. I think he's one of the best kickers of the ball at the moment. Like try his technique, try to look like it, and you'll feel all those little cues.
This is where I think we struggle with the young players quite a lot. It's noticeable over here now that young players don't watch as much rugby as we probably did back in the day, and I think the other countries do. Like me and Johnny, when we worked at the same academy, we would before sessions just have a bit of a knock around and try and copy, exactly as you said, like try and copy DC or something like that, who's got a pretty unique technique, and just have some fun. But you I don't think the players nowadays really know what a kicker is doing.
Right.
So that's probably one of the areas that we struggle more. So we need to get them, we're not necessarily watching full games, but we definitely need to provide them with some clips of pro players and say, just go and have a crack.
Yeah, definitely. But again, they'll be the guys on the team that do want to take it seriously. And I suppose if they are real keen, then they will be probably watching rugby. But as a coach, you can definitely have conversations around that, because we had the same issue. Like our girls in Australia, but we had to say, okay, who's a favorite player, one of the Aussie Super Rugby teams. At least you have to check in on how they're playing, what they're doing, why they're doing what they're doing within their technique, how they're playing. So it's a really good way around it.
Hey team, thanks for watching that Rugby Bricks YouTube video. Please subscribe to the channel. I want to point out the four passing sessions we have put together. What it is I coach you through these four sessions, 60 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest for 10 exercises. I coach you through, give you the cues, the tips. These exercises are drills that the professional use to keep their passing game sharp and keep developing their skill set. So I'd love for you guys to check these out. The link to these four sessions is below. I guarantee if you get through those 100 passing sessions, those really important coaches and selectors are going to really notice your skill standing out on the rugby field. Thanks for watching again. I'll see you back here again for another Rugby Bricks YouTube video.